still am, but have been a visiting assistant professor here at Haverford College, filling in for Nate Zillinger when he's on sabbatical. And it's just been my absolute joy and pleasure to work with this chorale orchestra for the past year. And I'm so happy you're here today to experience something old and something new. So thank you so much for being here. I want to speak on the first piece before we hear it, since it is brand new from shore, almost everybody. But this is called Songs of the Reef by Cassie To. Cassie is a contemporary composer. She hails from Sydney, Australia, and is a vibrant composer who works, who does things for concert stage, film scores, documentaries, TV. She really does it all. And there is a really beautiful cinematic quality to her music that I think you're going to really enjoy. You might be wondering, well, how did Haverford get to do the US premiere of this piece? And the answer is because of me. But also, so my dissertation research was on another work called Codebreaker, and I met the conductor who premiered that work. His name is David Temple. And when I was interviewing him, I asked him, hey, what do you work on next? He goes, oh, we're doing this new work by Cassie To called Songs of the Reef. And I was like, oh, that sounds super, super cool. And so I reached out to Cassie. She sent me the recording she had from the world premiere in England. Absolutely loved it. And I was like, yeah, we can do this at Haverford. So that's how we got to clinch the US premiere. So you're here for some history. Cassie's work explores the Great Barrier Reef and how mostly actually sound pollution disrupts the ecosystem of that reef. So we know a lot about just pollution in general and how it disturbs marine life, but she worked with a researcher by the name of Stephen Simpson of the University of Bristol, who really showed her that really it's the sounds of like ships passing and oil drilling that really disrupts the way that the animals and the reefs communicate sound-wise. And so there's a program note in your program from Cassie that I've given you her words exactly. I just wanted to read you the last paragraph of her note that kind of just sums up this piece. Songs of the Reef takes the listener beneath the waves and into the wondrous yet fragile world of the Great Barrier Reef. Although the impact of the noise generated by humans is alarming, it is the easiest pollutant to manage. There are ways for us to reduce it and coexist with the reef. It is all too easy to get so caught up in the constant bad news that we lose hope and we lose impetus. We switch off. So it is my wish that Songs of the Reef gives you a sense that all is not lost, that although the urgency is real, we can change our ways to help restore the reef and the symphony within it. So I just want to publicly say thank you to Cassie for this amazing piece. They are a full day ahead of us. So it's Monday morning in Australia, right? It's Monday in Australia. And so I'm actually watching at some point, but thank you to Cassie. I want to acknowledge a few of the people. The work includes some pre-recorded sounds. So you'll hear some of the sounds that Stephen Simpson has recorded. And today the sounds are being, our operator of the sounds is Spencer Brown. So thank you, Spencer, for doing that. And if this work wasn't complicated enough, huge orchestra, big choir, pre-recorded sounds. There's also a children's choir, and we've been blessed to work with the Haverford Boys Choir just across the street under the direction of John Sproul. So I'm going to welcome them to the stage, please. Cassie To, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
So while the singers catch their breath and prepare, I'm going to vamp a little bit for the Brahms. I do hope that you enjoyed Songs of the Reef. It's a really, really moving piece. I hope that you've enjoyed hearing the sounds and how they integrate into the piece. And so here's to more performances of Cassie's music on this continent, in this hemisphere. So thank you so much. I kind of started the concert with Songs of the Reef. I really wanted to do it. And I was struggling for a while to find the right companion piece, because it's a half hour, but it's not a full concert. And as luck would have it, the orchestration for the Brahms is nearly exactly the same as Cassie's piece, with just a few changes, notably the harp and percussion and piano and things like this. So it just felt like, logistically, that makes sense. But there's something else too, right? You heard, if you're a fan of choral music and you know your requiems, right? Cassie's piece almost feels like a requiem in some ways, right? We have this gorgeous kind of opening of celebration and pomp and circumstance, and then there is that middle section that feels like, you know, a Mozart Dixie Ray or a Dixie Ray from Verdi, right? It has that troublesome time. At the end, there's hope. And Cassie ends her piece with the kids singing as the hope for the next generation, right? And so now as we transition to Brahms, you know, we think about Brahms in such a, you know, he was a very troubled man. He was very particular about his music. And notably in his life, his friend Robert Schumann, the fellow composer, dies in the late 50s, and shortly after, his mother passes away in 1866, and he immediately begins work on what we will hear now as the Requiem. And he doesn't opt for the Roman Catholic traditional Requiem texts. If you don't know the Brahms Requiem, he builds his own texts, and we know it now as ein deutsches Requiem or the German Requiem, because he has built the text with the Luther Bible. He has found his own excerpts and put them together, and it is in German, right, as you'll hear today. And so Brahms is writing this piece over the course of a few years, and notably, he adds the famous fifth movement for soprano, choir, and orchestra, and it's, you know, one should be comforted as a mother comforts their child. So it really is the fitting kind of piece of Brahms' Requiem in some ways. You can read more about it in the program note, but I wanted to end with this last connection between Cassie and Brahms. To me, the Brahms Requiem has a very, like, earth quality to it, and you may have heard that Brahms referred to this piece as a human requiem. It wasn't for those who were lost, but for those left behind. And so in some ways, I think it's perfect pairing to have like this land and sea, and, you know, we struggle with what we've lost, but we have hope for what is to come. So I really hope that you enjoy the Brahms Requiem. It's seven movements, so we're going to take some pauses, so please hold your applause throughout. And then a final word, we're joined today by two extraordinary soloists. You can read their bios in the program. Our baritone today is Stephen Eddy, and our soprano is Dr. Kelly Mahler, and you will just be blown away by their singing, the choir, the orchestra, one of the most taxing pieces for the choir, so really be cheering them on as we go. If you've never heard the Brahms Requiem before, I really hope that you enjoy it today, and if you are a fan of the Brahms Requiem, I hope this is a good one for you. So please now enjoy Ein deutsches Requiem. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.